I remember her smiling. Most of the time she was smiling when she came around us. And I remember another thing I remember about Pam. She was always debating about something. And if you wanted to start a debate, just start up some subject. One thing in particular I remember, one time we had some math problem. Old Timbo had some math problem. I was helping him with it. And Pam said I was wrong. Well, it was all right, because I ain't gonna fuss with my mother-in-law. I said, that's fine. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. But she did come back and tell me I was right, finally. I got the math problem right. And that's what I remember about her. Whenever she came around us, we always had a good time together. Whatever we happened to be doing, we always had a good time. She was a fun, loving person and loved her music and her dancing. And my wife got that from her.
Yes, I did. I got dancing and music from my mom. And the most I'm amiss about her is her just being around. I can't call her anymore. I can't do anything. And I just want to say, Mama, I love you.
It's all right. It's all right. But you're going to say something. Do you remember about your grandma? What do you remember about your grandma?
Well, I can tell them what I remember. When she was over at our house, she used to babysit Carlos. Carlos would never listen to her. He always snuck the phone, whatever. And she said, Carlos bad as hell. Y'all need to do something about that. And Larry don't do nothing, Tiff, nothing. So I remember her always fussing at Carlos because he always been sneaky.
Hard-headed, that's what she said.
Yeah, she said, Carlos, hard-headed is a motherfucker. That's what she said.
That was the word.
So I'm just going to miss her personality, the realness of her. She was unapologetic, and that's exactly how I am. Absolutely. So she lived within me.
We're all going to miss her. We just
you think about my mom, what do you remember you pop up in your head about her?
Crazy, silly, outspoken, love her music. Love her family, love the dance, and she was my favorite girl. And very, very outspoken, very.
I remember Pam from the day she was born. Everybody loved her, was crazy about her. And I remember how she used to love, she enjoyed, Pam enjoyed life. She always had fun. She always was this star of the show. Come here, cuz.
Yeah, so we all loved her dearly.
She lived a good life, and if it's a heaven, I guarantee you she went there.
And I also can tell you this, she was a very outspoken person.
Yes, she
direct,
was.
Direct, and to let you know what's on her was. Mind.
Said what she meant.
That was part of the heaven tradition.
She said went on.
She was like her great Uncle Dave. Will let you know what he felt and thought of it right quick. Now, if I'm lying, his nephew here, and I'm his nephew, and has his nieces over here.
Thank you.
Yeah. I know she's going to be missed. She's going to be
gonna be missed. And you all going to miss her for
one reason.
Pam
was our first grandbaby.
She was.
She was the first grandbaby. She was my first niece.
Yep.
And we loved her dearly.
Very dearly.
And when we had her, we were scared to even pick her up. We had her on a pillow. We carried her around on the pillow. But she's going to be truly missed. Such an angel.
I'm going to miss the phone calls. COVID, that was keep your mask on, wear your mask. The phone calls, the messages.
Give us just a few more minutes and we'll open the doors.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Letting us know to be safe, stay safe. Pamela was a sweetheart. Still is a sweetheart.
I want my youth, I would call, make sure that I kept myself out of trouble. I want every phone call, every voicemail, and she'll let you know when she calls you on voicemail, saying what the day, date, what the time is. She'll repeat the message about 2-3 times. I don't miss the phone calls. And she always said, make sure she let us know her grandkids love her and all that.
Yeah, she did.
I'm gonna miss when the few times that I miss you. I'm gonna miss when she would always tell me be safe, have fun, keep your family near, and always be happy in life. I'm gonna miss her a lot, even though I didn't see her as much as I wanted to.
Okay, Shishi, what you gonna miss about your granny?
What you gonna miss about your granny?
Yeah.
You love her?
I love her a lot.
You love her a lot? Oh, so you're gonna miss her? All right. Oh,
love. I'm the little cousin, Missy. My cousin Pam was like a big sister to me. I was pretty much their baby. She was super, super outgoing. She was always with my older sister, Mother. They remember her as Pam in the red car with the boom bang in the trunk. She would be well missed. She was the life of the party, and we loved her.
I gotta tell this story. I remember when I first met Pam. That's when her and my Uncle Herb got married, and I will never forget. She had on this like turquoise blue dress, 80s, it was off the chain. It was off the chain dress. I should have bought the picture. We still got the picture. Okay. And it just, Pam was always a style icon. And that dress just was fabulous. And that was like her introduction to me and the family. And I never forgot that. I never forgot that. And she was always cool. We always hung out. She kept all of us when we were little. And just everybody just, she was just always the fun aunt. She was, I just, it's a lot. I will always remember that. She was the one that, I remember when that song, Around the Way Girl from LL Cool J came out. She used to play that for us all the time. So it was, I got great memories of growing up with her, just keeping us all together. And that was something that she always did.
Wait, and I got to do a shit
breakout
on this.
I know, right?
That's my mom, y'all.
A great memory of my cousin Pam, she's my heart's girl, is every time I was her present, she's always very loving, very caring, very welcoming, always just a bundle of love. And so she always had really great energy, and I always just love being her present. She's always so much fun.
She was a very special person in the band. I have one memory where I was at work one night, and I was standing there waiting on a bus, and she got on the microphone, the bus radio, and had three buses over there to pick me up. So I just want to make memory of that. She's very special.
Well, I personally didn't know Pam, but I definitely know her daughters and her grandkids, and I can tell by that she was a great woman. And again, we all love her and the family, and just God bless you.
Yeah, she was a great sister-in-law, a great mother, and a very fun person to be around. I have numerous fond memories of her, and like my brother said, you know, anytime we all worked at FedEx together, and anytime we needed transportation, she'd make sure we got it, and we feel blessed to have her in our life.
I remember about Miss Munn. I remember her going off about how Carlos was hard-headed. When I went to drop off Carlos' phone, she was going off the hike. She was like, he's so hard-headed. But she was always in good spirits, even though she was, you know, enduring, you know, some hardship with her health. So rest in peace. I'm sending love and light to the family and prayers their way.
She was my next door neighbor. And she always on the party bus with us. I'm gonna miss my auntie. She's so cool. She like the cool auntie. You know, she loves my baby just as much as she loves me. She gonna be truly missed, deeply missed. She loves looking like an angel. T.J. did a wonderful job.
Good afternoon. As you see, we were playing music because Pam liked music. So I think that you should be there and go the way you live. I had a brother-in-law, he rode a horse, and he said, when I can't get on my horse anymore, you got to take me on. I'm ready to go. Mm-hmm. But we're going to file the program as it is. We're going to start with a prayer from Elder Bagley. We can have the Old and New Testament scriptures by Reverend Brooks. We can have a musical selection by Miss Massey, and then I'll come back. Elder Bagley. Shall we pray? I need thee, oh, I need thee every hour. I need thee, oh, bless me. God, we thank you for your generous mercy. God, we thank you once again for this opportunity, God, to come before your presence. God, we just want to thank you for the life of this mother, oh God. Thank you for the time that you have given us, oh God. We know, God, she's in a better place. She's somewhere with the angels, God. We knew that you needed someone, oh God, that was a lively person, oh God, that loved to dance, oh God. One that could get the party started. God, we thank you for the time that you have given us with her, oh God. But now we ask you to look on this bereaved family, oh God. Touch them, oh God. They're gonna miss them, oh God. When they cry, God, you be there for them, God. But we know that she's in the bosom of you now, God. And we celebrate the life, oh God. We look at the memories that you have given us with her, oh God. The fun times, oh God. So we leave here, oh God, with uplifted hands. We leave here with uplifted hearts, oh God. And we're going to celebrate, oh God, her life, oh God. The way that she would like to do it, oh God. And we thank you now, oh God. It's not that we kept your commandments so well or that we did so good. But God, we know we come before a good parent, oh God, that has mercy and grace. We ask you to take us from this place, but not from your presence. Bring us back in the time that is appointed, God. And we give you the praise and we give you the honor. Thank you, oh God. Amen and amen. Amen.
Is my shepherd. I have all that I need. He lets me rest in the green meadows. He leads me beside peaceful streams. He renews my strength. He guides me along the right path. He guides me and brings him honor to his name. Even when I walk through the darkest valley, I will not be afraid, for you choose to be beside me. Your rod and your staff protect me and comfort me. You are a feast for me in the presence of my enemy. You honor me by anointing my head with oil. My cup overflows with blessing. Surely your goodness and unfailing love will pursue me all the days of my life, and I will live in the house of the Lord forever and ever. 23rd Psalm.
Because the Lord is wants me to do what honors him the most. That's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe.
I cursed God out. I kicked, I cried, I cursed him out.
I'm proud to say he gave me a number, you guys. When he first started, he gave me 5. Am I lying, Larry? What did God give me? Tell him. What number was I officially?
5. The number 5.
Miles, what number did I ask you to look up?
5. 5.
I knew my mama's departure date, so I can't cry no more. Thank you, God, for the time. I want to go just like her.
All right. We have another written selection.
with so much rain.
You're stronger than you think you are. You have more faith than you think you have. You have a lot of love for Pam. That's going to help fill it. And then the grace of God is going to top it all off. But as far as talking about here and right now, you know, many times we think that we know what's best. But in the end, God knows what's best. We just have to give a chance. As my wife says, she's waking many nights, I mean hysterical, just jumping up and down, screaming and hollering. Of course, if she's screaming and hollering, I'm up with her. And like she said, you can always find some word from somewhere when you're questioning God, and that's what she was doing. And I told her, we could go back to Job, and Job's wife told him, said, curse God and die. And my wife thought about cursing God. But that changed. She went from cursing God or saying something to God, asking why, to saying it's okay. To saying, God, I done prayed for you. I done as hard much as I can, but it's your will. I'm ready for my mom to go. If you're ready for her to go, I'm ready to go. And God turned around for her. Like she said, the fifth, she knew something was going to happen. And so as I say, you can always find the scripture. And I looked in Job and it says, and I think this is where my wife went. She said, though he slay me, yet will I trust in him. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So she went from there to here, but I'm going to go another place here now. Because I think sometimes when we have funerals, we get confused. So I'm going to go somewhere else. I'm going to go to Proverbs here. And in Proverbs said, my son, despise not the chastening of the Lord, neither be weary of his correction. For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth, even the father, the son, in whom he delighteth. So, Pam is gone. I can't give her any comfort. I can't say any message that's going to make any difference. But my message to you is, why we got to meet this way? What does that mean? Why we got to meet this way? It seems that every time there's a tragedy, there's a crisis, and then there's death, we all come together and we have a love party. But what happened in between? There was a tragedy in 9-1-1. We all came together as a country, as families. That was a tragedy. We loved each other. COVID came and we had a crisis. And we loved each other. Now death is on our doorstep. And we get together and we love each other. Then why can't we put out our petty differences all the time? Things that don't even matter, we just stick to them. I mean, things is insignificant. And I can't do anything about Pam, but I want you to remember this. We had a lot of crying here today. And sometimes you can learn something from crying. Your crying is not gonna help Pam. It's not gonna make any difference. But your crying may help the person sitting next to you. And what I mean by that, it may change your relationship. Every time you decide that you wanna do something over something petty, stop calling the people that you love. Stop communicating with the people that you love. Saying bad things about the people that you love and just doing things that's insignificant. The next time you think about doing that, think about those softer tears that you just had. Just think about when you decide to go on Facebook, as people do all the time, and say something bad about your relative, your friend, your coworker. But the one question you can ask yourself is this. You can ask yourself this: what would I do if that person wasn't here? How would I feel, all this animosity I have, how would I feel if that person wasn't here? I had a brother named, I got a brother, my brother passed, who was my oldest brother. His name was Gene. And for many of y'all, you don't know what long distance is, but back in the day, we had long distance. You called somebody long distance. We didn't have no internet. We didn't have no computer. We didn't have no Facebook, no Instagram, no Twitter. So what you would do, you would call them long distance. And my brother would call me sometime. He'd call me at 10 o'clock at night. Then he'd call me back at 12 o'clock. Then he'd call me at 1. And, you know, the first time he'd call, I'd be kind of awake, so I would talk to him. The second time he'd call, I may talk to him. The third time, I may hang up on him. And he'd all, and I hung up on him. He'd call me right back anyway. He said, "Brother, I'm going to tell you this." He said, "One day, you're going to want to hear my voice. One day you're going to wish at 1 o'clock in the morning that phone would ring. And it was my voice on the other end of that phone." And that was true. I got another brother named Lynn, and Lynn called me in 2012 Memorial Day. And I told my brother, I said, "You know what? I said, I'm going to come down tomorrow. We're going to barbecue." And that was Sunday. Sunday never came. And I know you know, that I don't know how many times I wish I could just hear that voice one more time. So when you decide that you want to be angry, think about that. But what you can do, you can be the best friend you can be. You can be the best son you can be. You can be the best daughter you can be. You can be the best of everything that you can be, because that will give you comfort. And I've got comfort in the fact that I knew I was the best son I could be to my mother. I knew I was the best brother I could be to my brother. But even if you think you were at your best, you will still question yourself sometimes. Because I asked myself, when I went to my mother's house, maybe I should have stayed a little while longer. When I went to my brother's house, maybe I should have talked to him a little longer. Because those things that you don't have now, you will miss. So that's just something I want you to think about. Put down your petty differences. Someone you love, you let them know it. Because they're going to be laying right here and you can't let them know it. And you'll be here with those salty tears. We don't want no more salty tears. Be the best you can be. Thank you. We're going to have acknowledgement by Carlos Fitzgerald. Come on.
We, the family of Pamela Munn, would like to thank everyone for your support and acts of kindness. During this time, our hearts are full of love and gratitude for all of you, for your prayers, phone calls, words of comfort, and visits. Special thanks to Methodist Hospital and the third floor staff for all of your kindness and special care.
We're gonna have you decide to read the obituary, and then we're going to have Reverend Brooks. The next portion.
Can we say praise the Lord? So good to, shouldn't say so good to be here, but in the position that we are, we have learned to tell the Lord thank you. And take our last breath, that it's not over. Jesus said that when we leave this place, that he will come again and receive us unto his own. I know that you're going to shed some tears along the way. I know you're going to find yourself in some dark times where you miss mama and you want to call on grandmama. But just remember the impression that she left on you. Remember the words that she's spoken to you. And just remember, she had a hope in Jesus. Knowing that when she leave this place, hallelujah, good God from Zion, that it's not over. She had a hope in him that he would rescue her and save her from the very snares of this world. Though our trials come upon us to buff us, they come to make us stronger. That's why the hymnologist wrote it best. He said, it is well with my soul. Hallelujah. We can take comfort in knowing that even when we leave this life, Jesus will come again and receive us unto his own. Directors, you can come at this time. I'm done. I know you're going to miss mom. Just remember, when you find yourself in those dark times, it's all right. No more pain, no more hospitals, no more suffering on this side. The things that we still got to go through every day. Worrying about whether or not we'll get shot if we go to the grocery store. Worrying if our next liquor run is gonna be our last. Y'all might as well talk back to me in here.
Amen.
She don't have to go through stuff like that no more. Don't have to worry about your Facebook post or what you said or how you gonna come back and say, I'm sorry. She don't have to deal with that no more. But she can rest and take comfort in the arms of Jesus. Hallelujah. My father used to say it like this when I was a little boy. He said, oh, I want to see him. Look upon his face. There to sing forever of his amazing grace on the streets of glory. Let me lift my voice. Cares are past. I'm home at last. Ever to rejoice. Hallelujah. It's all right. You can lift up your heads. Lift up your voice. Even with tears. Knowing that it's all right now. She's in a better place. God bless you on today.
Thank you all for coming. We really appreciate all the support that you've given us. My wife, our family.